Before we had these gloves, quite often the clients would be put off because they're like, well, but the fingers aren't moving. So it was a huge step forward, the fact that we had this real-time fingers that are moving in front of the client automatically just meant that we were more likely to get that job.
My name is Niklas Bote. I mostly focus on the OptiTrack system we're having, also the Unreal side of things. I program a lot for the showcases we do and wear a lot of hats as everybody around here.
I do a lot of the day-to-day organizational work that needs to be done, dealing with the schedule of our shoots, direct communication with clients, trying to facilitate how we as OnPoint could help them bring their idea to life. Because I'm not so in-depth with the software side of things, I'm quite often used as the guinea pig. If we need something tested, I'll be the one jumping into the suit.
Too much. Okay.
From an early point, we were very quickly to recognize how well the combination of real-time motion capture works with Unreal Engine. I always imagined being able to put on something like improv theater, where you have a bunch of comedians who are thrown into the suit on stage and then crazy thing happens that are influenced by the audience. They have to respond to it live on stage. This improv, real-time, instant feedback, the potential is there to embellish it with game engine technology, virtual production.
With a small team like ours, it's a challenge to get all the aspects of live capture going on a great level at the same time, with different characters, with different lens shapes, with different technical setups, to have it ready in a short amount of time. Basically to have a custom tailored setup running for every project and everything has to work.
We have quite a sophisticated system here. We have more cameras than it's necessary for the volume that we have.
The Unreal Engine pretty much is a pillar of most of the real-time work we're doing. OptiTrack Motive makes it possible to run a setup like this with a relatively small crew. And obviously there's also StretchSense, which helps us to bring the finger motion of the actors to life.
Then on top of that, we have the arkit workflow to get real-time face animation. With those three hardware technologies directly feeding into Unreal, we're able to put on these shows. So that's generally our workflow. People who come for a motion capture session, they expect there to be finger animation. We've been working with StretchSense for about 3-4 years now. We've been here from the very beginning. It was also roughly about the same time that we started as well. I kind of feel that we've both been growing as both teams.
I'm dumb and work better with colors than I do with numbers.
Right.
If it's green, it's big. Right. Right. Come on. You know what I mean? Whoever put letters in math, like, get out of here.
Big fan of the hand engine. For us who are used to working with Lifelink applications in Unreal all of the time, hand engine integration is pretty natural and just really, really amazing. Back in the day, we were also using the Motion Builder plugin, and I have to say, like, the development since then is crazy. You can really see the impact of every upgrade.
The support and stuff like that, it's always been absolutely fantastic. The team's always so friendly.
So far, every time we discovered a huge issue, we were able to get support pretty much ASAP. We're very much excited to incorporate the new gloves at some point into our showcases and play around with that a little more. We've basically just tapped into the whole VR potential that the gloves have as well. So yeah, there's still so much out there to explore and to get our hands on. And yeah, that's what I'm looking forward to.